New Black Ops 2 DLC, Microsoft unboxes the Xbox One, and Sony frees your DVR. All this and more on G-Tech. What is up, guys? Briar Rabbit here. I want to talk as quickly as possible about the new DLC for Black Ops 2. It's Apocalypse. It's four new maps for multiplayer, one new zombie map. The zombie map actually looks to be the most standout part. It's this Origins thing. It's got this giant robot. It looks pretty interesting for a zombie map. I'm not a big fan of zombies, but this one might draw me in a little bit because, you know, it just looks super cool. Especially, it looks completely different from anything we've ever seen in Call of Duty before. So I'm definitely going to check this one out. The four new multiplayer maps are a little less interesting to me. Two of them look pretty good, and two of them, I'm not interested in it at all. Pod, you know, but you never know until you see it. Pod is a failed utopian community from the 70s. They've left a bunch of stacks of residential pods on a cliffside, and that's going to be the setting for the map. So presumably there'll be a bunch of outdoor areas where that's very vertical, where you're jumping all over these pods, and then you'll be able to go into the cliff, and there'll be some kind of corridor shooting. That one looks okay. We'll see how it is. I'm getting kind of sick of the real tight spaces. We've had a lot of DLC that is really tight, so I'm looking forward to a little more rifle play. Frost might be that. This one is kind of a more classic Call of Duty map, it seems like. Fresh snow meets explosive gunpowder in this snow-capped European city, where the bridge over a frozen canal separates it into two sides. So this could be cool. The bridge probably will be multi-layered, you know, like a top layer, and you'll be able to run below it. And then since it's a frozen canal, you'll probably be able to run across the canal too, but you'll be left open to snipers or whatever. So that one actually looks too cool because it should be pretty symmetrical with the two sides of the city on either side of the canal. And, you know, some pretty interesting things could happen there. Obviously, we haven't seen it yet, so judgment will be reserved until we actually get to play it. But this one's got me most excited is Frost. Takeoff is the next one, and this is presumably a remake of Stadium from the first Black Ops 2. It actually came as a DLC map pack in the first Black Ops 2. And I didn't love Stadium in Black Ops. I'm sorry, the original Black Ops. I didn't love Stadium in the original Black Ops. It just wasn't one of my favorite maps. But presumably they're doing this as a remake, kind of similar to Firing Range, where they're just going to reskin it, and it's going to be a launch site in the middle of the Pacific Ocean. So hopefully this will be better than Stadium, but we'll have to see. Dig is kind of interesting. That's the fourth one. This is going to be set in a Afghani archaeological site. So that looks kind of cool. It's actually a remake of a Call of Duty World at War map, which I found to be interesting. And actually, that map is called Courtyard. I actually went back to World at War to try and get a gameplay, but the game is so hacked. There's like people flying around, and you shoot them, and they don't die. You can unload a whole clip into people, and they don't take any damage. It just got to be more frustration than I was willing to put into it, so I just decided to put this gameplay up instead. But, you know, Courtyard was kind of a cool map from World at War. That game is so old that, you know, this map could almost be fresh, you know, because so few people played World at War anyway. And, you know, it's been so long. It'd be nice to see something that's, even though it's a remake, it's a little older, so it might still be cool. So what do you guys think about the new DLC? Do you think it's, you still excited about it? Or are you just waiting for Call of Duty Ghosts? Or are you just ready to move on from something else entirely? Let me know in the comments. And next up, we have a pretty cool thing. Xbox actually did an unboxing. So they had Larry Herb, who is Major Nelson from Xbox Live. He unboxed the Xbox One. He did a whole unboxing video, and it was pretty interesting. And the thing that stood out in my mind was that he took a headset right out of that sucker, right at the bat, off the bat. He said, "Hey, there's a headset in this thing, so shove it, haters." You know, I was pretty happy to see the headset in there. I know I've talked a lot about the headsets in the incoming consoles, and putting that headset in there, I think, is a really good idea. It just helps get the community going. It helps people communicate and keeps people from using those Kinect sensors as their microphones, which is just going to sound awful. So check that out. I'll put a link in the description if you're interested in watching the unboxing. It's kind of weird to see a company do an unboxing, you know, 3 months before the console actually comes out. I can't ever remember watching a company do an unboxing on a console themselves, actually. So this is something new, but, you know, Microsoft is working really hard to try and get gamers back on their side. They did a lot of damage at E3 this year, and they've been really working hard to try and get the gamers coming back. So we'll see how this works. Yesterday, I talked a little bit about how you would need an Xbox Live subscription to record video using the built-in DVR on the Xbox One. And while it's not that big a deal, really, that you need that, it just seemed a little cheap to me by on Microsoft's part. There's really no hardware reason you need to have an Xbox Live membership to grab that video. And a couple people in the comments said, why would you want to record video anyway if you can't post it online and you'd need an Xbox Live subscription to do that? Well, you know, you might have a DVR or something, or a PVR that you could record on your own and you just use this as a backup. But anyway, you know, most people have an Xbox Live membership anyway, but you know, like Sony likes to do these days, PlayStation is not going to need have that same requirement. So, you know, as soon as they heard this news about the Xbox One, they came right out and said, you are not going to need a PlayStation Plus membership to record gameplay on the PS4. So this is Sony's MO these days, is, you know, they hear, they see Microsoft screwing up, they say, we're not going to do that, and they get gamers on their sides. And it seems to be working out really well. If judging from my comment section, I can tell that most of you are way more interested in the PS4 than the Xbox One. So, you know, just one more time that the that Sony just says, hey, you know, we're on gamer sides here. So that is going to do it for this video. Thank you very much for watching. If you liked it, please hit that like button. It really helps me out. It helps get more eyeballs on the video. If you're new to the channel, hit that subscribe button. Just hit that big red button right under the video, and up on the screen are a couple of videos you might have missed. Just click the video to bring you to the correct page, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.